Eamon O'Kane, listen, you've got two fights coming up, like a lot of fellas on this bill. You've got two fights coming up, and you've been in London doing a lot of sparring. You've been a bit of a busy boy this year so far.
Trying to be. As I say, I was hoping to be on the undercard of Kurt Frampton here in January. It didn't happen. So I've been training, ready for a fight, been around the weight since January. So I'm looking forward to this fight now, the 17th of March over in Sheffield. It's such a massive bullet.
Yeah.
Close to 9,000 people at it. And then this prize fighter happening after it. I don't like to look past the one that's 17th of March, but we're always chatting about this prize fighter in the minute, and it's exciting times for me and for everybody in it.
We'll talk about both of those fights, but in terms of your training, do you think that'll affect you in some way? Because the training that you do for a prize fighter is very different than the training you do for a 10-round fight, and you got two different types of fights coming up. How are you gonna sort your train out? Or are you just gonna fire on as usual?
I'm gonna fire on as usual to get ready for the 17th of March first. Then I'll look for after the 17th of March. Then I'll obviously change your fighting, because you have to shoot, make it sit towards the prize fighter style. So I'll leave that up to Nugget. He's the boss, and whenever comes to what type of training and what
you just do as you're told.
Of course, whenever it comes to that, there definitely has a strength condition coach, Ollie Cummins, who's very good as well. I'll let the two of them liaise and let them decide on the best mode of training for them.
So you've been over in London for 3 weeks, doing a lot of sparring with George Groves, preparing him for his fight with Kenny Anderson.
Yeah.
So they've obviously brought you over there to sort of replicate Kenny Anderson's style. Is that a compliment, and did you learn much out of did you learn much from those players?
Definitely it's a compliment, you know, to be asked and invited over there and to be looked after for 3 weeks was a privilege for myself and an honour.
Yeah.
You know, to be into a good gym, David Hay and all the side going on at that time. He was in training along with us just before he went over to Germany.
Right, okay.
And then he disappears to Vegas afterwards. He comes back in. And I can see nothing but nice things. He was a gentleman with his way to be nice to me, and I'm very grateful. As far as Adam Booth and George goes, they're great professionals in the way they deal with their business, and it was great for them. It was good to rub shoulders with them. It was good to be sparring with them. I assume they bring me over for Kenny Anderson in Summerside. He was a top quality previous gold medalist in the Commonwealth Games, and it was Commonwealth champion. So to be mixed with that caliber and
already, like
to help them work towards boxing against that type of caliber is a great honour. So I had a great, it was a great experience for me, because George Groves is a very talented boxer and a very hard puncher. So that not only did I have to be on my game, I had to be, it made me think as far as boxing was concerned, and I've been trying to work in different areas, improve. There's all a lot of improvement that I always needs to happen there. So there's never that complete boxer. So no, definitely I learned a lot, and it was a great experience, and I profited.
Do you can learn more in that in those spars? Because it was 3 weeks of sparring. That's a lot of sparring. That's a lot of rounds being done. Do you reckon you learned more in that sparring than you have done in your pro career so far?
You could argue, yes, because what I've done, it was an 8-5 and a 4 is what I've done, or not 8-5 and a 1, should I say?
Yeah.
And the quality of boxer that you're fighting against now, Joe Ray's a top quality boxer, but and some of the others that you're not, you know, that not at that level.
Yeah.
You know, George Groves is arguably in the top 5 or 6 in the world, possibly.
That's a weight, yeah.
You know, so it's definitely good to be mixing it with that level. And as you say, it's such a hard push, it makes you think you have to keep moving your head.
Because usually you like to, you know, come straight forward and just throwing bombs, hooks, every shot except for a jab.
I had to think outside the box of it, and I had to move the head a bit, because, you know, the head's movable there, so he definitely punches very hard, and he made me think.
In terms of your St. Patrick's Day fight, you got Wayne Reid. What do you know about him? Because he's also, he was in Prize Fighter as well.
He was in Prize Fighter as well. I thought he was actually lucky. He dropped his man in the last round.
Yeah.
So I don't know how he ended up losing, controversially.
But it was very controversial, wasn't it?
I thought he actually deserved to go through. He's a southpaw. He's a good boxer. And he comes to fight. That's what I like. I like people to come to fight, because then it's, I don't have to go chasing.
You do enjoy a tear up.
I do like a tear up, and I think that's what people want to come and see. Yeah, you know, as a boxer, that's what I want to see. Or watching boxing, that's what I want to see. And being a boxer, I think that's exactly what boxing's about. So I like to give the fans exactly what they want.
Yeah. Well, listen, how can people get a hold of you for some tickets? And
Eurospar. Centra is where we're selling the tickets.
Yeah.
Everybody knows around our area where to get them, and they're going out like hotcakes at the minute. I know they are because they only went and sealed last week, and it's exciting times around early with Paul McCluskey fighting and everybody. It's such a great bull. And I am promised to, as I say, bring all action on the night. So definitely come get the tickets there, and it'll be a great night.
Great. Listen, thanks very much for talking to us, and we'll catch up before the fight as well.
Come on,
cheers. Thanks.